नमस्कार, वेलकम टू माय क्लास सुपर केवीएनस पावर्ड बाय सुपर टीचर्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कवर द थर्ड यूनिट ऑफ क्लास फिफ्थ इंग्लिश, दैट इज रॉबिन्सन क्रूसो डिस्कवर्स ए फुटप्रिंट। यू कैन सी हियर इन दिस इमेज रॉबिन्सन क्रूसो इज देयर, ही इज जस्ट लुकिंग एट वन फुटप्रिंट ऑन द सैंड। सो व्हाट हैपन नेक्स्ट, लेट्स सी। Robinson Crusoe ship had been destroyed by the sea. So before going to start the lessons, let me show you that Robinson Crusoe's ship had been destroyed by the sea. He had been alone for many years and longed for company. One day he discovered a footprint on the sand, and let's find out what he did then. So Robinson Crusoe was traveling somewhere in the sea and his ship was destroyed. Finally, he find himself in an island where he was alone in the island. He was searching for someone there in the island, searching for some friends in the island. So one day what happened? He discovered a footprint on the sand. One day he discovers one footprint. There was some footprint on the sand. So he was very much curious to know that whose footprint is this. So let's find out what he did then. One day what happened? I was going towards my boat. I was surprised to see the footprint of a man on the sand. So one day when Robinson Crusoe was going towards the boat, he was surprised to see the footprint of a man on the sand. He was surprised to see the footprint on the sand. I stood amazed. I listened. I looked around me. When he saw one footprint, he was surprised. He tried to listen. He tried to watch everywhere. He tried to look everywhere, whether anyone is there. I could neither hear nor see anything. But there was no one surrounding him. There was no one there. I went up higher to look down. Then Robinson Crusoe went to the higher places of that island to look down, whether is there anyone in the island. I went up the shore, down the shore. I went up the bank of the sea, whether is there anyone, but it was no good. I could find no other footprint but that one. Even there were no other footprint also. There were no other footprint except the footprint on the river sand area. I went to it again to see if there were any more footprints and to tell if it had been my imaginations. Robinson Crusoe just went for searching other footprints, but there was no other footprints. He was confused whether it was my imagination or truly I have seen the footprint. But I was not mistaken, for there was exactly the print of a foot, toes, heel, every part of a foot. I could not imagine how it came there. The footprint was exactly like this. All the parts, the toes, the fingers, the heels, all part were covered there. So it was not my imagination. It was true. There was someone. I stayed a long time thinking, but become more and more confused. Robinson Crusoe started thinking that how the footprint came there, but he was more confused. At last, I returned home very frightened. At last, Robinson Crusoe returned to home very frightened. But behind every two or three steps, he was looking behind, mistaking every bush and tree to be a man. When he was going, you can see here, when he was running or going, he was looking back, whether is there any man following me or chasing me. Every bush or every tree he was considering like a man is there. When I come to my cave, which I call my castle, I ran inside it as if I was being chased. I do not remember whether I used the ladder or went in by the hole in the rock. So finally, Robinson Crusoe reached the castle, means to cave, as Robinson Crusoe was staying in a cave. He ran inside as I was being chased. He thought that someone is chasing, someone is following him. I don't remember how I used the ladder to went in. Even Robinson Crusoe forget that how he entered into the hole of the cave. I ran for cover faster than any animal could run. He was running so fast because he was frightened. He thought that someone is chasing him. I did not sleep that night. The more I thought about what I had seen, the more afraid I became. At that night, he did not sleep that night because he was frightened. I thought it could be one of the savages of the mainland. He thought that it could be one of the savages. Savages means huge beings who can eat the humans also. The mainland who had wandered out to the sea, giant. He was thinking it is a giant who has come to see to this island. Is there anyone else? Luckily, I was not on the shore that time. But what if he had seen my boat? Now he is thinking that I am so lucky that I, at that time when the savage entered to the island, I was not there. Otherwise, they would have killed me. They would have ate me. But what if he had seen my boat? But what if they have seen my boat? They must be knowing that someone is living in the island and they will return with others to kill and eat me. As they have seen the boat, they will return to the island and they will, no doubt, they will kill me and they will eat me. And so I lay fearful for many days and prayed for protection. Now he started fearing and he just prayed for the protection. I am doing so. I was much comforted and began going out to investigate. But even now, as I went forward, I looked behind me frequently because I was still very frightened. He was investigating the footprint, but still he was very confused. However, as I went about for 2 or 3 days and saw nothing, I became a little bolder. After 2 or 3 days of investigating, he found that there is no one in the island. Then he got little bolder. I decided to go down to the shore again and examine the footprint once more. Finally, what he decided to re-examine the footprint. I decided to measure it with my own footmark. I will measure, maybe that footmark belongs to me. That's why he decided to measure it with his own footmark. As I came closer to the footprint, I realized that it could not be my footprint because I had not come to this part of this beach since a long time. When he came closer to the footprint, he thought that it is not my footprint, as I have not come to this part since a long days. Secondly, as I placed my foot alongside the footprint, it seemed larger than my own. And the footprint was larger than the footprint of Robinson Crusoe. Means it was not his own footprint. My fear returned. I went home again, believing that there was someone there. The island was inhabited. So, after knowing that this footprint does not belong to him, again, he was frightened. And he returned home and he believed that the island was inhabited, means there is must someone in that island. This is taken by the Daniel Defoe's Robinson Crusoe. And now we will move to the New World section. You can see wild people, savages means wild people, or you can see giant of huge peoples, mainland, a large continuous extent of land, it is a mainland. Wander, go from place to place without a definite route. You are moving here and there. Bolder, more confident, become more confident. Inhabited, occupied or dwelled in, means someone is there. Inhabited means someone is occupied that place. So that's all for today's class about the explanation part of Robinson Crusoe. In the next video, we will discuss about the question and answer. So thank you for watching. You can visit my blog superkbns.blogspot.com or you can write directly at akm.kbs@gmail.com. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.